Are you ready to get out there and travel? But the idea of planning sounds daunting. Which map? Which guidebook? What attractions? Where do I stay? What hotel? What neighborhood? I got you covered. Coming up for you, 3 steps to planning your perfect trip. Kathy here, you're a travel time guru, flight attendant, photographer, and frequent traveler with almost 10 years experience in the airline industry. I'm here to share my travel tips, tricks, and adventures with you. Stick around by subscribing below. Just hit that red subscribe button and the bell next to it so you can receive notifications when all new content is posted. Everybody loves taking trips, vacations, traveling, seeing the world. Planning is sometimes the worst part of getting ready to go on a trip. So today I'm going to share with you 3 steps to planning your perfect trip. Step one is all about the research, and it hurts to have to do it, but it has to be done. Google is an excellent resource, though a bit daunting, of course. TripAdvisor is one of my favorite sites to hit when I'm going to a new city that I've never been to before. Tips to being a good TripAdvisor member is once you've been somewhere, make sure you go back and do reviews for the places that you saw so that you can help people pay it forward. Yes. TripAdvisor is not sponsoring this post in any way, although I do love TripAdvisor. I will make sure and put a list of all the resources in the description for you so that you have access to all of those. Another great resource is to check out people's blogs. There are probably a million and one blogs for every city in the world of top 10 things I did while I was in Rome or Paris. Go through and just make a quick list of the things that stand out to you, what sounds good to you, and then you'll be able to kind of work through all of that in the next step. Make sure and ask your friends. If you know people who've been to the city or going to, find out what they like to do. They know you well. They'll probably say, oh, I saw this shop that you would probably really love, or this restaurant we ate at that was fabulous. Also, use social media. Poll your friends on Facebook and Instagram. Put up a list of 5 things if you're having a hard time deciding between a couple activities. Put up a list and say, what did you like doing? Did you do this while you were in this city? My next big trip is coming up in just a couple weeks, and I'm so excited. I'm going to Rome for the first time. I've never been to Italy, and it's been on the top of my list forever. So I'm super excited, and I'm going to show you how I planned out my own trip to Rome. This is the way I get things done, and it has helped make it so much easier when I'm planning trips to sort through all of the information. So when you're going through Google, I mean, you know, you search somewhere like Rome, for example, and there are literally millions and millions of things that come back. And so it can be really difficult to sort through all of that, which is why I said check blogs, ask your friends, check TripAdvisor. So this is what TripAdvisor looks like. For example, if you go in and you search for Rome, you're going to see a list of, right off the bat, they're going to separate it into sections for you. Things like places to go, restaurants, places to stay, hotels, things like that. They're going to break it all down for you, and then you can just go into each of those individually. You can also just go to things to do, this things to do section up here. It's a really, really great way to see at a glance kind of the things people generally do when they're in that city. So for me, what I've done is I've made a list. My writing is awful. It is what it is. I can read it. So if you can't, I apologize in advance, but sorry, not sorry. So on here, I've just kind of gone through and made a list. As I mentioned, I've already booked a couple things, so I'll show you here. TripAdvisor is great. If you're booking tours through them, they partner a lot with a site called Viator, which is a big tour company, and they'll actually hold the reservations here under your bookings section. So you can see I have a couple tours already booked with them. Those are on my calendar. As I mentioned, sometimes you just have to book things in, even though I really generally don't do things on an itinerary, things that I want to see, I will book in ahead of time. So I have those things on the list here. The Colosseum tour you saw I booked, the Vatican tour, which is a really cool tour that TripAdvisor has started doing over the last just couple years, called Waking the Vatican. Now, I will tell you, this was a big splurge for this trip. This is my big thing that I spent a ton of money on. This tour starts at 6 a.m. You go to the Vatican. It's a 20 person or less tour. They do not book more than 20 people. It happens once a day and that's it. And what it is you go through the Vatican with the key holder, one of a small number of people who have keys to all these rooms, including the Sistine Chapel, museums, things like that. And they walk you through as they unlock the Vatican in the morning. Probably the biggest reason why I even booked this tour was because you get to see the Sistine Chapel with 20 other people max. So I'm really excited about that. Afterwards, you're going to have breakfast, and then they're going to let you into the museums ahead of all the crowds. So you'll have some time in there before they open to the public. So I have on here typical things you'd see on an itinerary for Rome: the Trevi Fountain, Spanish Steps, St. Peter's Basilica. These are a lot of them very popular attractions in the area. You'll also see I've kind of got some prices here. This is so that on the day of, I can decide, okay, yeah, I definitely want to do that. This is going to cost me $30. The Galleria Borghese, they have tons of artifacts and paintings and all kinds of things. So that's a 30 euro just for the entry, 60 euros for the tour with a tour of the gardens. They have beautiful gardens. I have this kind of information on here. I'm a big zoo person. I love to see animals in different areas. If you're ever in Australia, go to the zoo. Just FYI. Welcome to Rome, which is a three-dimensional presentation that I really want to see. It just gives a real background to Roman history. It gives you a 3D presentation of what the city looks like so you can kind of get an idea. I think that's probably one of the first things I'll end up doing. So this is just kind of a basic list. Now, this is where the important part happens. So you want to go and get a good map of the city that you're going to be visiting. And I have a few maps here, and I'll show you these. First, I went to AAA. I'm a AAA member. If you don't know what AAA is, don't worry about it. Or 3A, as my grandfather calls it, and asked them for a map of Rome. They didn't have any maps of Rome. So they had a map of Italy, which really, on this trip in particular, isn't going to do me a whole lot of good. But I am planning to go back to visit Tuscany in the spring. So we're going to hang on to that. As you can see here, I went to Barnes & Noble and they have tons and tons of maps, guidebooks. I basically took a copy of every single map or guidebook that looked interesting to me. I went over to Barnes & Noble Cafe right there in Barnes & Noble because they let you do this great thing about Barnes & Noble. And I sat down, I had a coffee, and I went through all these books. I looked at the different maps and decided which ones I wanted. Now, the important things for me when it comes to choosing a map to use, the size. So for me, this small, I mean, it's just, you know, the size of my hand, pop-out map of Rome is going to be very, very helpful. Because as I'm walking around, you know, I don't want to pull out one of these, open it up, and I've got, you know, ripping it. And, you know, you have, like, you don't want to walk around like that. You just don't. I try and blend in as much as is possible. So this pop-up map is really great. It's got a full map of the city and then a kind of a little zoom in on the city center. Now, what I like about this map is that it has lots of street names. So you can see, you can see not only the attractions and the different piazzas and museums, but you can actually see the names of the streets, which is super helpful when you're walking around in a place that you don't know anything about. And then kind of just a general city, a little bit bigger city view. And then there's, you know, the Roman Forum. They give you a little breakdown here, Vatican City. So you have kind of these at a glance, and then the Metro, which is super helpful as well. So I bought this one because I want to have this just in my bag. I can pop it out, be like, I'll know generally where I am. I'll know that I just left the Piazza Navona and started walking past this church. And so now I want to see, well, I'm trying to get, let's say, for example, to this museum up here. Well, I know that I'm going to need to, you know, turn up here on this street and follow So it's just for navigating, it definitely makes a whole lot of sense. Now, I also bought a second map. It's just very, very thoughtfully designed. It's cute and has, you know, all the different. So here, for example, where my finger is, this is the Trevi Fountain. And you can see that it gives you all the names of the streets around the area, the Trevi Fountain. Also, if you look here, like this R is a restaurant, Trevi. It also gives you the little dollar sign. So this is $1 plus. So that's a little bit more expensive than the cheapest place you can find. And it just has really cute little drawings of all the different things you can see. Here's the Pantheon down here, Piazza Navona. And also what they've done is you can see these dotted lines. And this is an insert on the other side of the map. So I'll turn it over so you can see. This is a good example because you'll be able to see it fairly well. So this is the Piazza Navona, and she shows a little drawing here and tells you it's one of Rome's best open spaces with dotted with cafes and local color. And then it'll kind of show you around the area, some history, restaurants, places to eat, places to shop, things like that. Another example is the Spanish Steps. So she has another little section for the Spanish Steps that just tells you all of the different shops that are located here and the things that you can see while you're in this area. I think it will make a fantastic keepsake, and I'll probably frame it and put it up on the wall after I come home. So now the other reason that I bought this map as opposed to the pop-up one, so you can see how small this pop-up map is. This is really just for navigating. This is so I can get around, I can pull this out, figure out where I'm going real quick, and then pop it right back in my bag. I don't have to pull out this huge map. Step two is organize. Now, the information gathering in step one is definitely the most daunting. This step to organize everything is kind of actually a lot of fun. I've noticed that there are pretty much two different types of travelers. There are itinerary travelers and there are non-itinerary travelers. Itinerary travelers like to know exactly what they're doing every day. They want to know where they're going to eat. They want to book in time for shopping, time to see sights. Everything is settled and set. And then there are the non-itinerary travelers, which is how I like to travel. Now, there's nothing wrong with either way of traveling. I'm the kind of person, I like to get up in the morning and see how I feel. There is a caveat to this, however, so I will mention that there are going to be times when you need to book a specific tour. One of the tours I'm going to be booking is a Vatican tour. It is a very small, once a day tour, and so it needed to be booked far, far in advance. So I just had to pick a day. So even though I'm technically usually a non-itinerary traveler, I don't really like to make a set plans if I can help it at all and just kind of go with the flow and see how I feel that day. There are going to be times that you're going to need to. Another prime example of this is if there's a really popular restaurant that you know you have to eat at. If you're going to New York City, Las Vegas, any big city where there are these really high-end or very, very popular restaurants, you're going to need a reservation and you're going to have to do that ahead of time. So those are sometimes the things that you kind of have to build in. So for my trip to Rome coming up, I do have, you know, four or five probably things booked into my trip that can't be moved. And the rest, I'll kind of see how I go. And I'll show you how I go about keeping things organized still, even though I'm a non-itinerary traveler. This is my organizational trick that I wanted to share with you guys. For example, I'll take this list of places that I want to see, and I'm going to mark them on the map. I'm actually going to write on this map. And I don't mind having things marked. For me, it's kind of a record of the places that I saw or wanted to see. If I ever get back to Rome and there were things I didn't see, I can reference this map. So for example, the Trevi Fountain is right here close. So I'll just put a little star right there, so I know that that's a little spot that I wanted to see. The Colosseum, which is down here on the map, kind of towards the bottom. So the Colosseum. Now, these are all main attractions in Rome, so I'm going to be able to find these things. You can get really great hop-on, hop-off bus tickets. I think two-day hop-on, hop-off in Rome was like 28 euros or something like that. And it basically takes you on a route through the most popular places in town, whatever city. And most cities have them. Dublin has them. Boston has them. New York has them. Paris has them. So you can get around that way. Now, I can use this to mark places that are not touristy. A good example of this is like restaurant recommendations. My sister said, please go to this one place, Bocce, and have gelato for me. I really miss it. So I'm going to mark those places on the map as well. I have a big list of these on my phone, but since I am currently filming with my iPhone, I can't get to that list right now. But I'm going to give you one example of places. So you can see here in Google Maps, I've looked at this place. This was suggested by some great travel YouTubers, Simon and Martina. Check out their channel. They're hilarious. They live in Japan, as far as I understand, and they just have tons of great information about Japan. But they did take a trip to Rome, and I watched their video, and they just raved about this place that they ate numerous times while they were there, called Osteria da Fortunata. And my Italian is not good, obviously. I speak Spanish. You can probably hear the accent. But and so you can see here on Google Maps that I have located this restaurant, and I found what street it's on and where it's located. So what I'm going to do now is I am going to translate that to my map and find it on here. You can see on the Google Maps here, as we kind of locate where this is and find it here on this our map here. So you can see on the Google Maps right next to La Carbonara, which is actually marked on my map here. And so we're going to add this place that I would like to go, which is about here. So I'm just going to put a big blue star. Okay, so I've marked that on my map. There it is. So what I'm going to do is go through and just mark a few more places on the map. And then I'll show you how I'm going to use this while I'm in Rome. So I have marked some spots on my map here. The way that I use the map now, zoom out a little bit here, is that when I wake up in the morning, I decide what I want to do. Maybe that day I really want coffee and gelato, which is pretty much going to be every day, by the way. But just as an example. So I know that a place that was recommended to me, the Old Bridge Gelateria, is down here, right? So I know that that is right next to Sora Margherita, which was recommended to me by a friend, Erin, who lives in Australia. She just raved about how great the food is. This is in what's known as the Jewish ghetto neighborhood, or the old Jewish ghetto. There's a synagogue right here. And so on that day, I might say, you know what, I am gonna go eat here. I'm gonna have gelato, and I'm gonna go to the synagogue. And I'm gonna do that kind of mid-morning. So that's an example of how I would use this map. You'll see here that the Pantheon here and the Piazza Navona are very close together. So all these things kind of in this area can be done in probably a few hours, depending on how much time you spend at the Piazza, how much time you spend at the Pantheon. These are a couple different restaurants, so obviously I'm not going to eat at both of them at the same time, but choose one and maybe come back for another. So that's an example of kind of how I organize for my trips, is I'll plot everything out on this map. By the time I'm done, I'll try and take a picture and post it on Instagram and Facebook so you can see it if I remember. And that is how I map all this out, and I can get a really good idea of where things are located kind of as a little group. So I know that if I am really feeling like today's the day I'm going to go to the Spanish Steps area and shop a little bit, I can do anything up kind of in this area with very little effort. I mean, I could crisscross back and forth, but in order to kind of save myself some time, especially in cities that are laid out a little bit more, I did this when I went to Sydney. I had all the places plotted that I wanted to go. And then I, you know, got up in the morning and I said, you know what, I really want to go do the tour of the Sydney Opera House today. And I went to a couple restaurants, had a glass of wine one place and saw different things in that area because my hotel was a little ways away. I wasn't staying right in the city, so I wanted to minimize the number of times that I was crisscrossing Sydney because it is fairly large. Step three, enjoy your trip. This is the easy part, right? You've put in the hard work, you've put in the time, you know where you want to go, you've made all the reservations and tour bookings that you need to. Now you get to go and enjoy your time in this new city. Here it is, your question of the day for today. What are your planning tips? What websites do you use? How do you go about building your itinerary or non-itinerary for your travels? Thanks for joining me today for three steps to planning your perfect trip. Make sure you subscribe by hitting the button down below and don't forget to hit the bell next to it to receive notifications on all upcoming content. Head on over to Instagram and Facebook and follow us there. Teasers for our upcoming videos, as well as plenty of behind the scenes pictures and videos. So now it's your turn. What travel questions do you have? Maybe we'll make an upcoming video about something that you want to know. So hit the comment section below and let us know what your burning travel questions are. If you enjoyed our video today, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and we'll see you next time on Travel Time Guru.